since the psychedelic era of the 60s. They've been a jug band, a folk band, a country band. They blazed a trail through bluegrass music. They were still playing those songs they cut on Will the Circle Be Unbroken today. They have changed American music. I have to say there's about maybe three or four bands that compare to it. And there is none of those bands that are still playing today with the vitality and the sound these guys still have. It is an honor to introduce to you this band. But first, let's digress. All right. As I say, we did the show with them back at the Ryman Auditorium. It was 2 years ago this September. And in that show, we were interviewing a lot of the people in the audience. And I would have to say this, I have not met a group of fans like the fans that came in for the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band. And these were 12-year-old kids that were talking about Fishing in the Dark. These were 70-year-old grannies that were talking about Will the Circle Be Unbroken. Mr. Bojangles. Uncle Charlie and his dog Teddy. Who's got that record? All right, represent. We got some deep catalog, and you're going to get to hear a whole bunch of it in a few minutes. So, if we are ready, please welcome a legendary American band that sounds great in the 21st century. Ladies and gentlemen, the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band.
This is actually, we started in 1966 in Long Beach, California, is where I mentioned. A bunch of surfers that play jug band music, which is typical dirt band, like, what are you, what? And, but 1967 being the summer of love, we decided we needed a little, we want to do a little folk rock music. So, we knew a lot of great songwriters. One of them was a guy named Jackson Brown, who was in our band when we first started out. Jackson was a real inspiration, except for none of us ever wanted to write songs for a while being in the band with him. So kind of took that slot. But there's another fellow named Steve Newman that wrote this tune. This was our first single ever. It's called Buy For Me The Rain.
Thank you.